Shouldered squats. So for this, we're making sure you're able to shoulder the bag effectively, picking the proper load depending upon your own individualized fitness level. Begin with the bag between your legs, feet are shoulder width apart, nice and tall to begin with. I'm gonna drive my heels, my hips back, heels are down to the ground. I grab it to the bag, underneath the bag, almost like I'm gonna do the bear hug clean. However, now I'm gonna bring it up and onto my shoulder. So it'll be just like such. Here, bring close to my body and onto my shoulder. At this position now, you're gonna make sure you're still aligned up, maybe adjust your feet a little bit, and you're gonna feel the bag wants to pull you to one side. This is why it's more challenging, because now the bag is in a different position and also it's creating rotational forces to my body. At this spot, I'm gonna drop down, heels go stay flat on the ground, hips go down, and I come back up to standing. Also make sure you're squeezing through those abdominals, through those glutes, keeping your shoulder blades nice and packed, down and away from your ears also for those shoulders. When you go down, you come up, make sure you go nice and explosively, squeezing your glutes and your abdominals at the top. When you deload the ultimate sandbag, you're doing the same process that you did when you brought it up. So it'll look like such, okay? What you don't wanna do is have it on your shoulder and just simply walk away from it. As firefighters or general public alike, if it's something that's worth picking up, it's worth putting down properly. So always do the same thing with the ultimate sandbag too. When you bring it up off of the ground, want to be able to control it, because there's risk of injury anytime you allow a load to just move freely away from your body.